So this is a mixed class of graduate students and undergraduates. We're teaching about cognitive science using simple robots as example cognitive systems. The students have been assigned to solve a little maze problem. So the robots are going to run around in these radial arm mazes. And hopefully the second time they run the maze, they'll be faster than the first time. The advantage of the robot over an animal or a human being is that we know what the right answer is. We know how the robot solves the problem. And so students can do cognitive science on the robot and find out whether their answers are correct or not. Whereas you can't do, when you do cognitive science on a person or an animal, you at best can hope that your answer is correct. And the robots are extremely simple. So if it fails for them, it's certain to fail for us. But it fails in interesting ways. And that's the point, is that you're learning how to think about information processing in a way that is like a cognitive scientist does. But the special thing is learning to do a little bit of software engineering, a little bit of mechanical engineering, snuck into their arts and sciences curriculum. So I've got three kinds of robots. I have the Lego Mindstorms EV3. That's the primary tool that we use. That robot is it's basically a mobile phone in a box. So it's a little arm processor. There's light sensors, color sensors, distance sensors, rotation sensors, and the outputs are motors. So it has drives its wheels or can turn its head around if it's got a head. Then we've got another robot kind, which is called these cubelets. And this is a non-programmable robot that you program by putting together. And so they can do simple things. And then the third kind of robot platform we have is Cherry over there. She can do very, very complicated things. She can walk across the room, pick up a ball, see what's written on it, or see what color it is, see whose face is drawn on it, and then make a decision based on that. So she can do all kinds of complicated things. So I tell the students that to get an A on their final project, they have to amaze me. And I get amazed pretty regularly, which is great. There's kind of the pedagogical part where there's the understanding of the cognitive metaphor, for the computer metaphor of cognition. So the idea that cognition is computation, that modern cognitive science and cognitive psychology is predicated on. And that's kind of a magical expression which comes to take meaning as you actually try to build a computational cognitive system in bit small. So that's great to see the students learning this thing. But the real fun thing is when the students get the robot to do something that I don't know how they got it to do it. And that's the most fun. Ta-da.